Facebook's parent company Meta is planning to build a $10 billion subsea cable that will stretch around the globe. But why does a tech company known for social media and ads need its own global internet highway? Is this about staying ahead of the competition, or is there something bigger at play? Let's find out. Subsea cables are the backbone of the internet. They carry over 95% of global data traffic, connecting continents and enabling everything from YouTube videos to online gaming. For decades, telecom companies like AT&T and Vodafone built and operated those cables. But in recent years, tech giants like Google, Microsoft, and Amazon have started building their own. Now, Meta is joining the race with its most ambitious project yet, a subsea cable spanning over 40,000 kilometers. But why does Meta, a social media company, need this level of infrastructure? Meta's platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp account for a massive portion of global internet traffic. Together, they represent 10% of all fixed internet usage and 22% of mobile traffic. Add in Meta's growing investments in artificial intelligence, virtual reality, and the metaverse, and you can see why they'd want a dedicated cable to handle all that data. Owning the cable outright also gives Meta priority access to bandwidth, ensuring fast, reliable service for their users, even during peak times. Meta is already part owner of 16 subsea cables, but this would be its first fully owned project. Meta isn't the first tech giant to enter the subsea cable game. Google owns or co-owns 33 cables, including ones connecting to the United States, Europe, South America, and Asia. Amazon and Microsoft have also invested heavily in subsea infrastructure, although they don't fully own any routes yet. For these companies, cables are more than just speed, they're about control. By building their own infrastructure, they don't have to rely on telecom providers, giving them greater autonomy and security. Subsea cables might sound like just wires under the ocean, but they're engineering marvels. These fiber-optic cables transmit data using light, allowing for near-instant communication across continents. Without them, the internet as we know it wouldn't exist. A single cable can carry terabytes of data per second, powering everything from video calls to AI algorithms. But building one isn't easy. It can take years to lay a cable, partly because specialized cable laying ships are in high demand and they are booked out for years. There are only a handful of companies worldwide capable of building subsea cables, and competition for their services is fierce. Subsea cables are critical to modern life, but they're not without their environmental challenges. While they have a relatively small physical footprint, laying cables can disrupt marine ecosystems. Construction can damage coral reefs, seabeds, and marine habitats. Maintenance can also be a challenge. Cables can break due to fishing nets, ship anchors, or natural disasters, requiring repair crews to disturb the ocean floor. However, some may argue that the long-term benefits of reliable internet connectivity outweigh those concerns. Cables are usually buried under the seabed to protect them, but this process can disturb delicate ecosystems. So why does this matter? By owning its own subsea cable, Meta is reducing its reliance on third parties, ensuring quality of service and securing its place in the future of the internet. But this raises important questions about control and equity. Should a single company have so much influence over global infrastructure? And what happens if this control becomes a barrier for smaller players? On the bright side, Meta's investment could bring faster, more reliable internet to underserved regions, potentially boosting local economies. If managed responsibly, this project could bridge the digital divide and create new opportunities worldwide. The key will be finding a balance between corporate interests and global connectivity. Meta's $10 billion subsea cable project is a bold step towards controlling its own destiny in the tech world. But is this just a smart business move, or is it a power grab that raises questions about corporate influence? What do you think? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Should companies like Meta own global infrastructure, or does this create too much power for tech giants? What's more important, fast internet or protecting marine ecosystems? Do you think Meta's cable will help underserved regions or just its bottom line? If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.